says fentanyl has come down here and it has taken a lot of lives. So we all need to be accountable for our actions.
For the ceremony for all our missing and murdered sisters, mothers, grandmothers, aunties, cousins, sisters, friends. Stand in the silence of prayer. And our brothers, and the fathers, and the grandfathers. But when our elders are leading, and we so disrespect, lay down some tobacco and ask for forgiveness. Because this is a day we honor and commemorate the lives of our sacred dearest of life who have been taken much too soon. Respect the elders, respect the medicine. You carry medicine when you carry your drums, when you wear a regalia, when you wear an eagle feather. This is where the respect has to be shown. This is where we have to be honoring each other and honoring the sacred grounds that the sacred givers of life have walked, struggled in, lived in. We have protocol in place. We've been doing this for 26 years. I also want to apologize. We made an error on the memorial march. And I have Mabel and Ipsang here.
We made an error. We made a mistake on when the first march began and when the woman's body was found. We made that mistake and we take full responsibility for that. And I want to apologize to the family. From our hearts, we apologize. And we should have been more on the ball. There was no excuse for what happened. And I hope that the family will forgive us. Thank you very much.
I am Soto Creed from Keene First Nation and work at Waver Rape Crisis Center as a counselor for the families of the missing and murdered Indigenous women. I started walking in this march as a teenager with my mother, Edna Brass, in the mid-1990s.
Manitoba and me too. Hello. we talk about the loss of loved ones, we also gotta remember all the life givers that are here with us today, right now. Where's all the life givers? Humility, but there's also a struggle in there. We can't not talk about that today. Everybody struggles in their own way, whether it's mentally, emotionally, physically, but it's up to us to be strong for one another. And sometimes that's hard, especially for the single mothers. And I'm a single mother, I have six kids.
My roots roots go all the way down to Alaska. And it just embraces my soul. Because now I know where I belong. And so I work down here for a lot of our lost sisters, grandmothers, aunties, cousins, people who need laws. And hopefully we're going to lay a solid foundation so that you can all be up here. You will all be doing the memorial march. You'll be having to deal with the crowd and deal with everyone. And we're building that foundation for you. As you heard, a lot of our young voices speak up. They're so smart. They're so, you know, when you lead by example, you have to be the role model. So I think what's happening right now, there is coffee in the Amazon front door, there's washrooms there, there's washrooms here, but when we move forward, honor the medicines that are in front of you. Honor them because we're honoring the sacred lives that walk these streets, that struggled in this system. We're going to remind you over and over, honor our elders. If you're walking in front of an elder, step back and allow the elder ahead. The reason we want the elders in front is because we have two vans. We want to make sure they get tired or they something happens, we can put them in there. So we have a few stops and we're going to be moving that way. So we have the flower girls, we have the elders with the medicine, and then we have
Oh! last
time. Final sister speaker, and we're on our way.
Hi,
my name's Helen Tommy. I'm from Florestown. My dad's from Kuntu, Kitisu. And I'd like to thank everybody for coming out. No matter what race you are, no matter what age, you came out and you supported us. And I'd like to say that it takes strength to go against what they have taught us. What they put in our books. What they put in our minds. That we are to be looked at as not okay. That is enough of that. There is enough hatred in this world. Now it is time to be humble and be happy and be human. Enough of this looking at our differences. Enough of this looking at what is better about myself rather than you. We are all equal in these matters, and we all matter. Sisters, brothers alike, the one thing that we have towards us is that we're human and we need to start putting that towards ourselves. Look to one another. Stand with one another. Help one another. There's enough of this profanity that is happening to us. We do not need this hatred in our heart anymore. My job here, I'm a medicine woman, soon to be two-spirited. But my work now is I'm going to school to become a worker for. Because I'm Aboriginal, that is not right. We need to start working together now and start making things better for our children. Break the cycle. I'm 6 months clean now and I could not have gotten there.
Thank you.
this is why. Yeah.